Hi everyone, welcome to How Inez Rolls. Now, today we're doing something different. We're doing a family Q&A. So I have some wonderful questions from some of my friends, and I'm just gonna bring everybody together and we're gonna be answering your questions today. So, let's get ready. Okay, here they are. And here they are. This one's in middle school, so you could tell he's so thrilled to do this with us today. So I thought it would be fun to just ask my friends if they had any questions, and we have some good questions. So I'm gonna ask everybody, and I also have some really cute pictures I can show, and I have a surprise for you at the end. Ready?
Oh, yeah.
Go. All right. So Lisa Blackman, she asked, when I decided to start a YouTube channel, what and how did your husband and, or I guess, what did your boys think about it and your husband think about it? What'd you guys think about me starting YouTube?
Expected?
Well, because we were such good friends with the Phillips that they had been trying to get me to start a YouTube channel.
Both of us.
Yeah. Paul's got one too. Please be careful.
I've been supportive. I'm too tired when I go home from work to work again, so I don't like doing my stuff.
And plus yours is like more project oriented. It's not something that can usually be done quickly. Like it takes time to paint or
projects cost money too.
Yeah. It does cost money. Okay. We'll go on to the next question. All right, so we have another question. It is, if any of the boys' friends watch my YouTube channel.
Yeah.
He actually told me about a story about a girl coming up to him, an eighth grade girl. He's in sixth grade, so eighth grader.
Yeah.
And what'd she say?
That I had good dance moves.
So she watches his dance moves. Aw, that was cute. All right, let's see. I know Paul has co-workers who watch.
Yes, I do.
So not all of them are subscribers, so, you know, I'm just grateful that people are watching. Okay, so how old are the kids and what grade will they be going into?
I'm going in first grade.
He'll be going into first grade. How old are you?
Six.
Yeah, he'll be seven in December. And then we have two older ones. Kobe is almost 17 and he'll be a senior next year. And then we have Isaiah, who's on a mission, and he will be 19 in the fall. So we have them kind of spread out about every 5 years or so.
Right? Isaiah and Kobe are 20 months apart.
That's right. The first two are much closer in age. So we have some really good questions from Jen Bowles. She said, what do you want to be when you grow up?
A police officer.
He wants to be a police officer? That's the first time I've heard that. Do you want to be a police officer in Vegas?
Mm-hmm.
It's a little scary out there. What about you?
Probably a journalist.
Journalist. Wow.
Actually, I want to be a firefighter.
Oh, a firefighter. That's pretty cool. Do you know those guys, they play lots of video games and they eat lots of food? We have a couple of friends. It's not easy but once you do, I almost feel like it's a fraternity of sorts.
Well, there's long hours and they're away from their families for a long time.
That's
well.
True.
And it's high-risk work, and so there's some pros and cons.
Yeah, Paul's really good friend is a fireman. Mm-hmm. And but he's like the cooker. Like, he cooks all these really great meals for them. Right, that's what Anthony does. All right, what's the best thing about you?
I'm cool.
Oh, well, how about humble? Ezra's cool.
I'm flexible.
Oh, okay, so that's a little known unknown secret, right? Like, I guess I'm telling you now, is he's like Gumby. He can flex in a bunch of directions. In fact, he's so like loose in his limbs that his shoulder dislocates a lot. Sad, I know, but
yeah, it hurt. It's, you can tell it hurts him.
Yeah, it's just that he's
and he screams and says it. That hurts.
Where the doctors have said that he's loosey-goosey, and unfortunately that doesn't give this mama comfort. And I know with time it's just going to get worse, but hopefully it will get better. I mean, I'll just be optimistic. So,
what's the best thing about Kobe?
He is passionate. He's always been a little bit passionate about what he believes in. He wears his feelings on his sleeve, right?
He's thoughtful.
Thoughtful. And Isaiah?
I think he's learning the humility and thoughtfulness and caring right now where he's at.
Yes.
Isaiah is very driven, goal-driven. He sets goals and he meets them. Mm-hmm. Whatever it is, whatever. He mapped out his future and he mapped out with goals along the way, and he's hitting all these milestones and these goals all the time.
It's kind of one of the things, it'll help him with what he wants to be after his mission is something in the medical field. So we're really excited to watch what happens. What about you? What's the best thing about you?
You guys.
There's so many things. He has to think about it.
I'm an artist, but I don't really do any art anymore other than like little projects I do. But I've been published a couple times for drawings that I've had and won a bunch of awards in art shows. But I saw that artists don't make any money, so I didn't go into that field. And
fair enough.
See, I like to overlearn on one thing. Like, if I find something that I like, it could be anything. It could be grilling outside. It could be tools or
designing a deck or shed, or he'll just put a lot of focus energy.
Building a rifle, anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
Then.
So he learns as much as he can about
one thing. I overlearn it until I...
I don't think you can overlearn it. I just think you are being...
I learned so much about it until I feel like I'm proficient in that one thing.
And so that's good. Those are good things.
It can also be a bad thing. Because then I get tunnel vision. I'm like, ooh, I want this. Ooh, I want that. And that happens too often.
How about me? Best thing about me?
I'll say
you like your channels?
You what?
I like your channel.
You like my channel?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You always put others in front of you. Maybe even to a fault.
Okay. Wow. I think that's a mom trait. I mean, right? Am I right? Is that a mom trait? Let me know in the comments.
But it's always like, oh, this is cool. Maybe so-and-so will like this, or maybe so-and-so will like that. Or I was thinking about this, about so-and-so, and I'm like, dang, I always think about myself. I don't think about others as much as you do.
So I think of others. I do think a lot about others. I am observant, so I feel like I am aware about like surroundings, and I'm aware of like needs of my friends or just likes and dislikes. And I'm also not one to just sit around a lot. Like, I have to do stuff. So, like, that's why I work from home, and then I can do the YouTube thing, and then I'm making dinner, and then I'm cleaning the house, and then sometimes I think about in the future, you know, what would I like to do in the future? So those are fun things for me about me too.
You're also big on nourishing relationships with your friends and family. Like, you want them to be strong, as strong as they can possibly be, those relationships.
Well, I think that's important, and we've talked about this a lot too, is it, you know, we've gone through, I think, times in our life where we, you know, were really busy with little kids that we didn't get to see our friends, and we had to kind of pick up where we left off. And sometimes it could be like a year we wouldn't see like certain friends, and it would be fine. But I think we're kind of at a stage in our life where we do feel like it's important to nourish our, or attend certain friendships. All of our friendships have, you know, you're my friend, you're gonna know it. And I think that's important. I wish I didn't have that thought too, is we'll pick up right where we left off, because I remember thinking that in my 20s. Mm-hmm. And now that I'm in my 40s, it's different, right?
You're in your 40s.
I'm in my 40s, what? So is Paul. All right, Jen Bowles also asked, what would you like to do this summer?
Jump in the pool.
Oh, swimming in the pool.
You already Disneyland. Did that.
Disneyland, oh, what?
I agree with him, isn't it?
Well, we are gonna go visit my dad, and maybe a possibility. We'll have to see.